Thank you. Good afternoon and welcome to the Liberian Diaspora Forum Weekly Talk Show. Obviously, this is a special edition. We usually air on every Sunday at 8 p.m. Tonight, we are doing it at 5 p.m. Minnesota time, Central time. That's because our guest, Honorable Jim Salinsatiba, is calling from Miller Mice away in Liberia. And as you know, many times when we host guests from across the Atlantic, we do have to make accommodation, you know, due to time difference. But what's interesting is we have Jim Salinsatiba on the line with us, and like I've always said, with certain guests, you really don't need to introduce them because there's not one person on this line who does not know Jim Salinsatiba. I'll be willing to bet that. So with that said, I'm not going to waste time with any introduction. We all know who the man is. We know what he's done for Liberia. Instead of introducing him, I might introduce myself. I'm Kafumba Kruma, and I'm the host for the show, as always. So, Mr. Jiba, I'll turn the floor over to you for your brief introductory remark, and then shortly after that, we will begin attending questions. May I add that the question lines are open. Star 61 is what you need to make entry to have your voice heard. So, Mr. Jiba, the floor is yours, sir.
I'm Jim Salinsatiba, formerly of the Liberia Lone Star Soccer Squad. My purpose of being on this show is that, as you all are aware, I'm contesting the presidency of the Liberia Football Association. And one thing I want to clarify is that my decision to contest the presidency of the FA was not based on any personal vendetta against disability. My decision was based on the fact that I think our football program is at an impact. And having been in the vanguard of this this discipline for X number of years, I think I have the ability to move our program forward. You see, hello?
Yeah, hello, you are. Go ahead. We're listening. Yeah, go ahead.
As I said previously, I said I'm not against disability concept for football development. Keep breaking it. Can you hear me?
Yeah, we're hearing you. I can hear you loud and clear. Yeah. We can hear you.
As I said, I'm not against, I have no personal vendetta against disability. I think I'm against his concept of football development. His concept has not yielded fruit. And therefore, I have a better program that can move our football program to another level.
Okay.
To be quite frank, the FA has only existed under the nomenclature, but it has not been proactive.
Okay.
That's how I feel.
Okay. Yeah, okay. So you want to leave it at that and begin to take any concerns, comments, or questions, or you stay going? Are you done, or you stay on the floor?
Oh, yeah, I'm done. I'm done.
Okay. All right. Well, yeah, that's plenty. That's plenty. Once again, I want to thank you for honoring my invitation to come on the Liberian Diaspora Forum Talk Show. Ladies and gentlemen, you've all heard the man that we've all come to admire over the years, football psychology legend Jim Salinsatiba. He's with us tonight, and the thing he's come to talk about mainly has to do with his intention to contest the LFA presidency comes next election, which I believe is next year. His opening remark pretty much focuses on the idea that he's not running because he hates Musa ability, but he does think that he has better plan to improve football in Liberia. So with that said, if you have any comment, concern, question, this is the time to make your voices heard. You may dial *61 on your phone so that I'll open up your line. And you may begin questioning, making comment on or expressing concerns. While we await that, let me begin by asking Mr. Diba as to whether he know, Mr. Diba, do you know, well, first of all, do you know whether in fact Musa Benete plans to run for another term? Because we know he's the chairman right now, comes next election. I'm not sure if he plans to run for re-election. Does he? Have you found that out? So because the reason I ask this question is that if he's not going to be contesting, so it should not be anything about him at all, because after all, he's not running anyway.
Exactly,
he signed his term, and then he signed his
term.
No,
no, no, he is. He's going to contest.
He is? Okay, all right. Okay, so
yeah,
he's contesting.
Reliable sources, and I think he himself came on the air a couple of times and made that clarification.
Okay. So that's good to know that. So with that said, I'll take our first caller for the day. The no name, your last four digits, 2170-2170. So please tell us your name, where you're calling from, and your question, comment, or concern for Mr. Diba. 2170, your name, where you're calling from, your question.
Hello?
Hello, you on. What's your name? Where
yeah,
you calling
hello,
from?
My name is Elijah Janja B. Also a former footballer from Liberia. I play for Liverpool from the Oro, and I also play for Liverpool Barrow, a Manway Sport Association.
Okay.
Coming to the States.
Yeah.
You guys know me very well, and I'm an all-time scorer.
Hello, hello. Hey, Jay, what's up?
Okay. I'm an all-time scorer. Well, I appreciate that, but I just want to say something to Diva, you know. He said he has a good player for the FA. You know, Diva, we all know he played good soccer back home, and even going to professional.
Yeah.
My personal friend, I appreciate all the type of celebrated goals he scored for Liberia. But, you know, I'm a little bit, you know, and a little bit confused when you're talking about he had good plan for Liberia's LFA, because his whole career, Diva has the ability in his career to have emulated other people to expand the development career. All of his career, he did not improve anybody to at least give the invitation. I really appreciate all his ability of his career, all of his day he played. So what is the confidence that to prove to us that he can make a good management to make the football program to develop in Liberia? Because if you excel to that level and you are not able to see somebody dream a vision to excel to that level too, so what is the trust and confidence that the Liberian coach imposed to him now as a celebrated star to prove to us that he can make a difference? There are some
thank
of the
you
questions.
Very much.
Thank you very much. Yeah.
Thank you very much. I will first tackle the first question. It's obvious, and I will say this again, as I said previously. I said, having been in the vanguard of this discipline for X number of years, I mean professionally, I think I'm in a niche position to move our football program forward. And number two, your second question was, you did mention I was not involved in the assistance of any other player, as you said. I think, you see, I'm not flamboyant. So a lot of people will not know my contribution of football in Liberia over the years. But I have been involved in the career of Azitono. I helped nurture Christopher Rare, Azitono, and even Kevin Sibley. I was one of the main pilots that instrumented their going over from Liberia to France. You can ask him; they will attest to that. See, but the problem is, I don't ring my own bell. You know, I was always there mute. I would let people speak for themselves. When I'm in a niche position to move our football program forward. I mean, our football program is at an impasse. Look at our league. The National League is substandard. The referees. I mean, look at all the different facets. Everything is down. Unlike the George Weah era, look where we were. Eh? Liberia football was on a pedestal of international relevance. But look where we are now. Almost a decade later, look where we are. I mean, it's sad. It's sad. And we need to tackle this. We need to tackle this situation by the gonads, or else we're slipping.
Okay. All right, Olivia, I will take the next caller here. Folks, if
Thank
you just
you
joining us, yeah, if you just joining us, and I know I've noticed a lot of you just joined us, Let me remind you, we have Jim Salinsa Diba on the line with us, and he's talking about his decision to contest LFA Chairmanship during that election in 2014. If you have any question, comment, or concern, please star 61, and then we will open up your line. We'll take the next caller here. 1373, I believe this is Senior, 1373. Please confirm your name, where you're calling from, and your question for Mr. Diba.
Yes, Brother Kurman, thank you for taking my call. Let me say hi to Honorable Diba. This is Sayan Yawana from Brooklyn Park. Yeah, I was just calling because, thank you. First, let me thank you to Honorable Diba for your services to our country, Liberia.
Oh,
and I think
welcome.
You all
thank
have contributed.
Much.
Yeah, we
I'm
appreciate
grateful,
it.
Brother. I'm grateful.
No, thank God for you. Yeah, thank God for you. But let me ask you, Honorable Man, because I've been following you, I've been seeing you, you know, with the power of the beast, if you allow me to say that. I just wanted to know, what's the transition been like from the professional soccer player to soon to be politician, or if I may say politician? How is that transition like?
I'm not a politician. I'm far from being a politician. James Alenza Diva was a professional player, always been and always will be. You know, but as it is written, Aristotle once said we all have some political orientation. But I'm not a politician, my profession. I'm a professional soccer player. Hello, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here. Diba, go ahead, I'm here.
As I said, there's nothing like a transition. I didn't go from being a soccer player to a politician. I'm not a politician. I am a professional soccer player. Always will be.
Okay, thank you. For any reason, you have a follow-up question, you know, that's star 61, as we always do. Many of you have been on this line many times. So we'll take the next caller. Moving on, we'll take 5728-5728. Could you please tell us your name, where you're calling from, and your question for Mr. Diba?
Thank you. My name is Bangali Trowale, calling from Minnesota. And I just have two questions for Honorable Diba.
Okay.
Mr. Diba, I'd like to thank you very much for taking the bold step to vie for the leadership of the FA of Liberia. But this is a huge challenge, and some of you have been wondering why people of your caliber have not, you know, made a strive to take on this thing. And because we believe in you people so much that we feel that you have the exposure and what have you to take this organization further. But I'd like to start the question by saying, you, Honorable Diba, given your level of football, you're a talented football player, like you said, you're not being a person, you're being a football player all along. But coming to take on leadership, I don't want to call it politician, you know, talking about technical leadership. We all know to have somebody to take on a particular position, you might have been vetted, your track record might have been reviewed. We all know nobody play for Lone Star if you never feature for any of those five division teams in Liberia, so to speak. What is your track record when it comes to administration? It can be captain, it can be team manager, it can be sport administration, in whatever level, be it Liberia or international. What's the track record that we can look at and say, yeah, Diva is a kind of people's person, he can relate, because leadership is different. You have to relate to people. You're gonna miss.
Exactly. But listen.
Yeah, 1 minute.
I don't know, Mr. Diva,
he got two questions. Wait, let's take all of his questions, then you can begin.
Yeah.
Mr. Trawala, you done?
Just keep that question with respect to your trial record, where you bring it on the table for us.
Okay.
The second question is, I was reading something off late about you making a contact with a player that have been admired by people so much so that having him on Lone Star will give Liberia a different flavor. I think one name in England that many other people have.
Yeah, Alex, Alex Nimnes.
Yeah, Alex Nimnes. Fine. But from my reading, it was like you have infant on him, and for sure you're going to get him. How far are you going with that? What you think is you, not other person can bring that? What is it that you have done? What is the position now with your negotiation with him? Just those two questions when you comment on. Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah, go ahead, Mr. Diva.
Yeah, I will first start with the second question, the question that has to do with Alex Nimland. You know, I don't know how far the FA has gone with this, but Alex Nimland is my prodigy. Is a prodigy. I've been tutoring this kid for the past almost a decade now, and we've been having some chit chat. So we're trying to bring him over. I think I'm in a position to bring him over to the national team. And number one, your first question was my track record. Okay, look, I don't know, you know, with no disrespect, I don't know if you've been around any professional institution. Professional football is different. It's not only going on the field and kicking balls. They teach you the different aspects of football development. So having been in his establishment, having been in the vanguard of this discipline for approximately two decades, I think I'm in the next position. I think I know where it is to develop football.
Okay. All right, we'll leave it at that unless he makes a follow-up entry. But before I take the next caller here, I have a test message question
yeah.
Here. The question read that.
Go ahead, sir.
I have a test message question. The writer writes that you talked about recently. You quoted in the paper saying that if you let it, you were concerned with the world best soccer player. Once world best soccer player George Oponwia to. You know, you are hanging with him, you know, to improve football in Liberia. And so the question is that if you didn't support George Weah for his ambition in the presidency, why would you expect George Weah to support you?
Yeah, but listen, regardless of our diverse political ideologies during these elections, during the presidential election, George Weah is a well-meaning man. This is an institution that George Weah helped to craft. George Weah will not sit back and allow things to go down the drain. As I said, our program is at an impasse. He and I, we had, you know, we talked a couple of weeks ago when he was here, and we had a plan how to move football forward. You know, nobody should think that, oh, I didn't support George Weah during the election, but politics is what it is. You know, football is different. Football is different. George Weah helped he was one of the forerunner in crafting his institution. He will not sit by and allow things to go down the drain. No.
Yeah.
Know the kind of person he is.
Yeah, that may be true, though.
This is not politics, my brother.
You said in your opening remarks that things are going down the drain right now, and George Weah is sitting back. Why they go down the drain? So when will he come on board? When you take over as the head, that's when he will come help. And so think about that for a second. George Weah will not sit down for LFA to go down the drain. But yet in your opening remarks,
yeah,
you said that with Musa Benitez, which I agree, by the way, things are going down the drain. But the interesting thing is George Weah is there, right there, right now. So why is he allowing you to go down the drain now and wait till you come on board?
Oh, George Weah will definitely come on board. You know that I'm running for the presidency, he will definitely come on board. George Weah has been passive because, look, he partially became a politician.
Okay.
But,
all right,
as I said, yeah, I had a talk with him a couple of weeks ago when he was in Liberia. And we have a plan.
All right. We'll take another caller here. This is Flomo, 1296. Flomo calling from Brooklyn Park, Minnesota, Destiny Debater talk show host. Mr. Flomo, welcome to the Liberian Diaspora Forum. Your question for Mr. Diva.
Thank you, Baraka Fuma Kromat, host of Liberian Diaspora Forum. Honorable Talin, sir, how are you, sir?
Yes, sir. I'm okay, sir.
It's nice to have you on this program, and this shows that you are truly a brother. And
Thank you.
Understand that we have problems at the football, the airfield. This is not a question.
Yeah.
I would like to know, because I personally would like to have my family vote for you. Is that a process that the ordinary Liberians will be taking part in this process, or just group of old folks?
Unfortunately, the voting process will not every Liberian. We have the executive committee members. We have those that include the presidents of the various football associations. That is the first division team, the first and second divisions, and the subcommittees. I mean, the various the different 15 political subdivisions.
Okay. So it's unfortunate that
It's confined to those. Yeah, it's confined to those within the. Yeah, it's not everybody. Just anybody can vote. No.
Okay. That's a good clarification. I've been wondering about that too.
A lot of people been asking the question, my brother. A lot of people been asking the question.
Yeah. Folks, if you're just joining us, and many of you still continue to come on, and I expected that. We know we're bringing a star on tonight. Our star in all regards. So many of you have come on. So now is the time to dial *61 if you have question, comment, or concern.
Okay.
Or at least if you just wish to say hi to Jim Salinas and Diva in your own words. We'll take a follow-up caller here. Brother Senior came back with a follow-up question. Brother Senior, welcome back to the show. What's your follow-up question?
Welcome, man. Thank you so much. Let me just follow up quickly. You know, Honorable Diva emphasized, you know, his assurance that Mr. Weah will come on his side. And one thing he said, which is very critical, I wanted to bring back to his refreshment, is he said, you know, I mean, politics, you know, that Aristotle, that everybody somewhat, you know, is a political animal, to paraphrase. But politics is interest. Yes, and politics is interest. I want to say, you know, Mr. Weah spoke, Ambassador Weah spoke sometimes last week or so, as he said. But why? Let me rephrase this question in another way. Why did you choose Madam Johnson Sirleaf over your own good friend and brother, Mr. Ambassador George Weah?
You see, politics is interest, and now you're seeking his interest.
So why?
I won't call it being intruding, but let me just say something. That is why I don't do these interviews. I asked from the beginning, I told the moderator, this is not a political forum. We're only discussing football. This is not political.
Okay. Yeah, you did say that. So, folks, as much
no,
as
no,
this
but,
is...
Hold on.
As much as it is hard to, you know, to determine what each caller will say, but I do ask that maybe I should have said this right off the bat, that the guest, Honorable Jim Salinas Adiba, has indicated to me that he wants this conversation, this forum, to be strictly about football and not politics. Now, I know it's hard to separate the two, but just try. If you can do that, we'll appreciate it. Maybe we can talk politics at another time, but tonight, the guest wishes to discuss sport, football, and football only. So, Senor, with that in mind, you want to refresh your question?
I will certainly do that, but let me say for the record, because I am a strong supporter of the program, and I want to respect the guest's wish. You know, the only reason I mentioned that, because he talked about running for LFA. He's seeking his friend, you know, some NSF that's politics, but I will respect his wish, and I want to respect the show, because I'm a strong member of the show, so I will respect his wish. But I thought
thank
this could
you.
Be an opportunity for him to clarify the act, for be having all kind of stuff. So maybe this could be an opportunity for him.
Stay on.
Yes, sir.
The mistake a lot of people made is that you cannot equate the presidency of the Republic of Liberia to the presidency of the FA. You see, the FA is just a minute or component of government. In fact, the matter of fact, the FA is not political. It has nothing to do with politics. It is strictly football.
Okay. That's interesting.
Anyway, thank you very much, my brother. Thank you very much. I really appreciate it.
We'll take the next caller. We'll leave it at that. And But Diva, let me apologize if you know if you hear questions that you didn't anticipate.
No,
but like I said,
it's okay.
The good thing is
a lot of these
people that are here would not be here if they didn't know who Diva was, if they didn't like Salinsa Diva. These are all concerned Liberians. And I think, quite frankly, some of the questions that we avoid today will continue to come. You know, whether on this show or on a show, as you come, you know, to the limelight for an LFA championship, you will have to deal with these questions one way or another at a different time, maybe not tonight. We'll take the next caller, 6929. I don't know where you're calling from. Please tell us your name, where you're calling from, and your question for Mr. Diva. 6929.
All right. Well, my name is Clarence Gono. I'm calling from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania.
Welcome, Mr. Gondo.
Okay. Mr. Diva, how you doing?
How you doing, sir? How you doing? I'm okay, man. Thank you very much. I'm okay.
Okay. My question to you is just simple. I used to know of a guy, Famula. Famula used to play for Geon Professionals. And Famula was sponsored somehow by one of you, George Weah, or one, somebody in Liberia. He went to, I think, Austria.
He did what?
He went to Austria. Famula. Yeah, he went to Austria sometime. And then all of a sudden, he went to Austria sometime. And then all of a sudden, I found him in Nairobi. He came to Nairobi, and then he was looking for a place to start. And he came to my house. And then Famula came, for some time. Famula started playing for professionals. He started playing for Gor Mahia. Gor Mahia is a Nairobi, it's a Kenyan team, like a, you know, those style and battle.
Okay.
Iron battle team. Gor Mahia is one of the best of the national football team in Kenya.
Okay.
He started playing for Gor Mahia, and then all of a sudden, everybody in Nairobi started liking Famula because he was very good. So then one day I asked Famula, you are very good. Look at in Nairobi, Kenya, everybody loves you, the way you score goals and all of that. He said, well, no, our big girls in Lone Star, they can't promote us. So that you, George, we are all the big guys, you guys, they didn't want to promote younger folks. And then Famula left there, he couldn't go anywhere, and then he left, he went to Tanzania, Dar es Salaam. And then he started playing, and then all of a sudden he said, John Weah said he can't promote me. He couldn't even tell me to Italy. He couldn't even call me to come to Italy. And I said, but then why did he approach Salinsa? He said, is it possible to get to Salinsa? So my impression was that you guys don't promote younger folks, you know, because of certain reason that you have.
But, that's not true. You can't blame me or blame Ambassador Weah. How will you determine where a Liberian player is? We have no scouts to go around and look for Liberian players. You see? I don't know the name you just mentioned. I never met the lad. I think I heard of him. But I really don't know who he was. I never met him before. You see, we've been involved in the promotion of players. How you think, as I said previously, how you think Christopher Red, the likes of Christopher Red, Kevin Sibley, and all you got went to Europe? Well, because of us. It was because of us.
Okay.
No, I never heard of him. I heard of him, but I never met him.
Okay. All right. We'll leave it at that. Mr. Gono, by all means, if you have a follow up question, make a new entry. Start 6-1.
Yeah.
Until then, we're moving on. 6105. Please tell us your name, where you're calling from, and your question for Mr. Diva. 6105.
Thank you so much. My name is Anthony Aram Zaidi. I'm calling from Maplewood.
Welcome, Mr. Zaidi.
Thank you. Let me just begin by giving you thanks for your programs. I think it's one of the best I've come to know, and the way
thank
you control these programs. Again, I was just a little bit concerned that I think you should go beyond just a phone conversation. I think. The media, I think, require attention. I mean, require a lot of attention. To be honest with you, you have been able to bring people from the diaspora, people from Mondeland, to share our common view and goal. So I really, 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 really enjoy your program and admire what you are doing for Liberia.
Thank you.
Thank you. Okay. Now I also want to give thanks to your guests. Mr. Diva, I just want to say thank you so much for the service you did for our country. It was during your time
Thank you.
That we enjoy peace. During your time, we used to have good time in Liberia. Ian Barrow, Mr. Solisa don't play, or we are don't play. The team will never be interesting.
By the grace of God, we'll bring back good times. By the grace of God. By the grace of God.
Thank you. Really, really, we are grateful for that. I'm sure that you may not have been retired honorably like some of your folks in Europe may have done, and that is probably because the government maybe don't have such a system to really compensate you guys while you're there. But I think we can make...
Thank you.
Let him go to the question.
My question is this. In as much as I admire you, your way of playing, dribbling, I don't want to say play better than we are. I think you're playing at the same level. But we are able to accomplish something that you did not.
Okay.
I mean, you may have accomplished something, but from the level I saw you playing, we are I said it very faster. Was there something that you did not do well, not on the basis of playing, because we know that you play very well, but in terms of promotion or in terms of contact, was there something that you did not do well and if we should reverse back 25 years ago that you would do that would make you to go as you did not do for the past maybe 25 years?
Okay.
Thank you for your question. The first thing I want to tell you, I'm grateful. I'm grateful for your acknowledgement. And I wanted to tell you that you see, success, the word success, I think, is relative. And if you want to know the level of my success, you have to check my track records. Yeah, you have to check my track records. Because a lot of people don't know what I accomplished in Europe for the various clubs that I play for. So you have to check my track record. I think I'm hugely successful with regards to where I came from. And what was the next question? I've forgotten. The government didn't give us the right, the kind of appreciation that we deserve.
Right.
I think, President Kennedy once said, he said, not what your country can do for you, but what you can do for your country. I think we put Liberia on a pedestal of international relevance when it comes to soccer. And I'm proud of that. I'm very, very proud of that.
Okay. All right. Before I take the next caller, let me ask you this, Badiba. I told you earlier that we've been hosting many different people on this show, one of whom happened to be David Coty. We hosted David Coty the last time. And in the process, a question came up saying that there are a lot of former national team players, former Lone Star players, roaming the street of Monrovia with nothing to eat.
Yeah.
Some got no place to sleep, no food to eat. They are not the same people we used to know. So my question is, under your administration, were you to become the next LFA president, what plan do you have for those people, those former national players that are walking the street now, homeless, if in fact they are? Do you have any plan for such people?
Well, I have a platform. I have a platform that is very impressive. That covers all of that. Former national team players as well as even present national team players. Back in the days when we were playing, players were receiving stipends. Nowadays, no player getting stipend. You see? And what happened to some of the ex-football players that we have? You see, the problem here, if you don't have that, if you're not affiliated with the power structure, your chances of getting your point across is obscure. But I will make sure, I will listen to all these players, whether present or former national players, I will listen to them and see what they have in store. What can they bring to the table? You see, that's what I would do.
Okay. All right. Well, we'll take the next caller here. 7905. Please tell us your name, where you're calling from, and your question for Mr. Diba. 7905.
Yep. Thank you so much, Mr. Moderator. My name is Duana from Brooklyn Park, Minnesota.
Welcome, Mr. Duana.
Yes, thank you so much and appreciate it. I just want to say thanks to Mr. Dubai for appearing on the show. And I think this is a very great opportunity for a lot of people to know exactly what's going on and how best we all can contribute in the process. Again, my name is Duana. I did not play for the national team. But I have three questions. The first question for Mr. Duba is, has to do with, number one, what is the information that we are hearing in terms of, Ayi Jatta, which is Georgia, bro, of his concussion. What contribution are you making towards his treatment in terms of coming? And not only that, also we heard about a lot of people that are dying, former athletes, player, someone that did not play the game. There are a lot of them who are dying because there's nothing set aside for rainy days. And some of these people are dying, and sometimes the government does not help, especially so some of them even play for the game, for the country. And when they die, nothing happened. For example, we had the late Bob Cooper, we had the great Gianni Lane. We have a lot of these guys who pass away, and nothing has been done towards the formation of an athlete in Liberia. I know you can't do this alone. You're going to need some help from a lot of other people to accomplish your agenda. One person cannot score the goal. One person can score the goal, but a lot of people do the pass. So what plan is in place to have a formation of an athlete senior? I know that's something that you and I tried to talk about several times. And hopefully we can all contribute in the process. But what is the aid that the government does not have anything in place in terms of social security for some of these players when they play for the national team, and at the end of the day, nothing happened. And these people die. We have to sometimes collect money and do other things. Then is there anything in your plan towards that? Thank you.
Yeah, but thank you. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much. I don't think the players are dying because of some of the illness reasons you did mention. I think it's hard to say it, but players are dying because we will all die. The inevitable conclusion of life is death. We will all die, definitely. But what I want to say again, that answered your question. The first question was George Igbo. Yeah, George Igbo conditioned the speedo. He had a concussion 2 weeks ago. And
hello?
Oh, my battery is running dead. The government. Oh, my God, the battery is going dead.
Wow. Hello? Okay, folks, Jim Salinsa Dima has left us. He said his battery gone dead. Salinsa Dima is a credible person. I truly believe his battery went dead, but it's worth noting that when I called him 2 hours ago, as a reminder, we agreed that the phone was going to be on charge. So I assumed that the phone had been fully charged. So, of course, I don't know how well the phone keeps energy, battery. So, but he's left us, and until he returns, I don't know. I'll probably make a follow-up call if he does not return within the next few seconds or so. Few minutes or so, I'll probably try to make a follow-up call to see if we can have him back online. In the meantime, Flomo was waiting in the queue. I don't know if Mr. Flomo?
Yes, thank you, Veronica, for my...
Yeah, so yeah, the guest has left us momentarily. Hopefully he'll make a comeback.
I know he's surely going to come by because it's necessary that we have a guy like the James Salinsa Dima on a conference like this because he did his share, he helped out, and we should give him at least something everywhere because there are people, I believe, at the LFA that did not play soccer. And all they are there sitting there doing is to steal from the Liberian people. We need people who have done something in that arena to be in position, not just people who have money to pay their way to whatever position they're sitting in. So I think, again, Brother Jiba, James Dima, if this was a process where Liberians, we have the opportunity to vote, I think through fair election, you'll be able to get to that job. But this is not the case yet, because my question was whether, you know, the ordinary people will have the opportunity to vote, but this is not the case. So I cannot actually see that he might succeed in doing it, because I know there are people in a race with him that have a lot of money in their pocket, and they got there because of the same bribery other people. So let's just leave it like that.
Okay. Well, your point is well taken, but and I agree. It's unfortunate that the election is only among selected few. But let me also caution you that just because Jim Salisa Diba play good football, that does not usually or always amount to good administrative, you know, output. He can be a damn good player on the football field or on the field as a whole. That doesn't make you a good administrator. But I agree with you. I think if anybody going to be LFA chairmanship, I certainly should be people who been there, done that. And Diba, by all means, is one of those. So I agree. Your point is well taken. And let's see what Brasil has to say. Brasil?
Yes, sir. Yeah, I think you are on the money when you responded to our dear brother, Mr. Flomo. You know, two things I see happening. First, Diba, I will call him honorable because he's our guest, so we must give him that respect. Honorable Diba is shying away from the over-aching question about his relationship with Mr. Ambassador Judge Weah, particularly when it comes to what transpired during the elections. He's also in the political process. I think his backing, I may be dead wrong. If anybody knows it better than me, please do that. Come on and share with us. I think his backing is banking on the president's support, you know. But the question Mr. Flomo asked, if this process were open to all Liberians, I don't know whether they were, unless it goes back to UP and CDC approach. But I think people are still bitter for what he did to Mr. Weah. You can't underestimate that. You know, all the good things he said about his good friend, now he wants Mr. Weah's blessing. But when Weah wanted his blessing, no, he didn't see that. This could have been an opportunity for him to clarify the air, you know, but he's trying to dodge it. But, yeah, again, we have to respect his wish. And based on the agreement both of you had, so I wanted to respect that. But he keeps talking about politics. And if you talk about politics, then you should get ready to get involved in politics in political discussion. But you can't think politics, then you talk football. Then you have beyond football, you talk politics. The whole process they're going to do is politics. You know, they're going to campaign, they're going to spend money, they're going to lobby for vote, that politics. So how can you evade that? But the topic is touchy when it comes to why did you not vote for your own brother and friend? It's a tough thing to do. You know, sometimes people do something, the aftermath is what lives after you, and that's why I'm catching up with him now. You know, I understand, you know, everybody has right to vote how they wanted. That's very true, that's how it should be. But in the time where your brother needs you, you have to think twice. Either you support him or don't support the next person. But you get support the next person over your brother, then now you come and ask for a vote. Anyway, Mr. Weah will decide what to do with him. Two brothers, they will handle the game.
Mr. Singh, I could not have said it better. I completely agree with you. But I noticed, though, I am reluctantly, you know, very much respectful of our guest's decision, you know, to not discuss politics, even though it's so hard to separate the two. But that's what he chose to do, and we'll see how that works. If you just joining us, Mr. Diba Lyon has left us momentarily. He says from Patrick went dead, so I assume it's just an assumption. I assume he's making an effort to come some way. If he does not come within the next minute, I'll try to call him to see if we're going to continue the show or not. But in the meantime, you may dial *61, and I'll open up your line so that you can share your thought with other listeners. We've got a lot of people on the line, and it's only fair that we keep the conversation going. So let me see. Oh, okay. Let me see. 0042. No name. Please tell us your name, where you're calling from, and your take on the subject while we are with the guest.
Good evening, Mr. Moderator.
Good evening. Good evening to you, sir.
My name is Coach Kasimoyam Sila. I'm former national team player and also serve as assistant national team coach and founder of the Kasumu MC Lab Foundation, an organization geared toward the development of youth through sports and providing educational services for kids affected as a result of the Liberia Civil Crisis. So I was very glad to be on the show.
Thank
and
you.
Also to listen to my teammate and Liberia's most celebrated star.
Mm-hmm.
But I said that he's not on the line, but I will also want to share my thoughts with other meaningful Liberian that would like to know exactly some of the things that's going on within the Liberia football arena. Again, my name is Coach Kasumu Mcila. Presently, I'm coaching here, trying to develop 3,000 youth in the area of Atlanta with the United Football Academy.
Thank you. So, hello?
Yes, I'm there.
Okay, all right. So, that's what you had to say for now, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. And if I may remind the audience, folks, the reason we are able to host Jim Salisa Diba in the first place is because of the fellow who just spoke. As a former team member of Jim Salisa Diba, he worked up the modality. He did enrichment. So I want to publicly acknowledge his effort. And what I say, I also want to ask him if you'll be kind to see if he can call his friend, our star Jim Salisa Diba, to see if we're going to be able to get a hold of him for the rest of the night. If that's it, then maybe we can know that. So, Mr. Sila, if you could do that favor for me, I would appreciate it.
Okay, let me hang up in 1 minute quickly, and I'll get right back to you.
Thank you. Please do. All right, that was Brother Kasimu Sila, a coach in the Atlanta area, former Lone Star goalkeeper, former Lone Star player. We'll take Anthony Zeze. So, Zeze, what's your take on the subject while we are with the guests?
Yeah, thank you so much. Just for the sake of conversation, and I think most of these dialogues are good for our country. You know, when we recognize the weaknesses of any department, being sport or whatever, that the nation should benefit, we have to talk about it. And again, that's why I give you thanks and appreciation for your programs. But now, I know Felisa is off right now. I heard him talking about his battery. I think his battery is still dead. I'm not sure he will come by online. But as group, you know, the young man that just... Yeah, hello?
Okay, yeah, keep talking. So let's not call him myself. You keep talking. I'm going to talk to you.
Okay. Yeah, you know, as group now, a Liberian, I'm talking about we Liberians now. We have seen some of these people that have worked for the country. Like, sport is one of the best in any country. We know what sport has done in Europe. It was as a result of sport that Europe is experiencing the peace today. They're always to be in chaos. And we know what sport has done in our country. And somebody mentioned that some of these guys who play for our national team end up almost dying disrespectfully. In other words, they were not really honored as they should have been. And that's a serious problem. What it means is probably we never have vision or the structure in place that these guys, at the end of their retirement, at least should be well taken care of. I think if we can start talking about these things and maybe let the government know, because we got to push on that. It's not just people that play sports. We are seeing other people that are giving services to Liberia and they end up really dying, just some of them out of poverty, leading to hunger, to death. We saw Jake Scout, former justice minister, almost eating in the dumper, the picture someone else saw. That was really a disgrace for our nation.
Hello?
Yeah, I'm here.
Are you still on the floor?
Just for the sake of conversation, I was just talking about putting structure in place so that people that are giving services to our nation cannot just at the end of their service, I mean, just let them go like that, you know? I mean, we can speak about it. That's what I was trying to say.
All right. Thank you for your contribution. Folks, Salisa Diba just called me, and he just got a new charger, and the phone is working perfectly. He's coming back home. That is the good news. The bad news is that He's at a program right now. That's where he was when he got on the show. So in other words, he never should have, you know, been on the show to begin with, but he did so, honoring our invitation. And so therefore, he's coming back to take a few more questions, he said. He's coming back now, not for no more than 20 minutes, unfortunately, to take a few questions, and then that will be it for him. So we look forward to his return, you know, at least for the 20 minutes, and then we'll move on. So until while we await his quick return, 2170 had made an entry to offer his opinion on the subject while we await Salinsa Diba. 2170, your name, where are you calling
hello?
From, your contribution.
Hello?
Hello? Yeah, hello?
Hello?
Hello, you on? Hello?
Yeah, I beg you, man. I really want you to keep me on because I have a lot of things for to discuss with Diva. You know, I was the first caller. And Diva, I said, you don't want to blow the horn. I mean, to inform people, but less as a whole, you have to inform people your ability, who you assist for them to know your character. We all play football in Liberia before coming to the States. And less is being recommendation and contact, networking. From James, I mean, from Josh Weir, and Borchardt, now the only people that I know are on the top there that were promoting Liberian players, besides the boy who went to Asia, Fala Johnson. So is Diva is telling me today that he helped Joe, I mean, he assisted, and Kevin
Christopher
Red. No. He got to convince me because myself, I played Wufa Division down there before I came to the States. Diba, this guy was given invitation by Josh Weir. Even Josh Weir came everywhere to get up to Europe. Because my father said, play only two games before he said in Europe. Josh Weir came with these guys, and he found documents, white paper for them, and hooked them up on the first division team. I'm informed with all of these things. I'm telling you, I never said I want to get a James Alisa Diba, but left as a whole, you got to be networking, you got to be connected. You can't tell all that we trust our football body with you in your whole career. You did not see nobody drink. When you go back to Ghana, I bet you probably have an academy. He sparked a lot of young generation to take them to Europe. And I bet you probably wanted to contest for the Ghana Football Association. When he saw the professor that came into the race, he backed up. You know why he backed up? He backed up because the services that men ran with him in the future. I bet he Pele had to. And I bet he Pele will go to contest. Ask anybody or Ghanaians. If you are going to contest with that professor, you are going to beat him. But he realized when he was coming up playing for Temoria in Ghana, that was the professor that assisted him doing his football career. So he back up to give the men the support. That's why we talk about other corner score in the program. Say, look, why you had to battle against your friend? Give our own way to the United States. Look, I tell you, me, I did not play a national team level, but I played third division, and I was second division highest scorer. You know me good. We all were there. Why some of our players right here, they did not see our dream. I'm not against them. But Diva saw other people, you could assist them that play to the level of him. He never assess and see the dream and vision today. Unless it's dream and vision, nothing gave Diva invitation to go to Europe. Well, Josh Open, we have given them the invitation to take them to Europe. All of these guys, you can call them, they will ask you, they will tell you about that. That Masa Gio, Joe Nambe, Kevin Sebe, all of these guys, Josh took them in a horse. They were starting with Josh Weir. You know what I mean with somebody? You know how many players even went for trial in Europe and they were let down? Sakba Yanze were giving invitation. I mean, Josh Weir recommended Sakba Yanze. You went to Euro, you failed. I didn't try to give you an example. So even people gave you invitation, you can still fail in your football career. But Josh made it possible for these guys to become somebody. You think why Joe Nambu said he would be the last person to criticize Josh Weir? Because you know what Josh Weir did for you. James Weir played the same
table. I'd like to suggest this. Since Diva has promised to make a comeback for at least another 20 minutes. I'm going to keep you where you are. I'm going to close your line, but I'll keep you in the queue. As soon as you come back, we'll reopen your line so you can make your follow-up question,
right? I want to just tell you that. You said if nobody should keep that, you know, kind of promotional factor. If you promote people to yourself, it's not secret. that while Borcha had an academy in Baton, Borcha was promoting players. So if you escape players to promote them to that level, then you say, oh, you gotta blow your home. No, not informed. We all in Liberia. James Diva did not help nobody's football career.
Okay, stay right there. Yeah, just wait. Wait for Diva to come. Stay right there. Casino Sila is back. I believe he got a message for Mr. Sila. Were you able to get a hold of Diva? Actually, he did call me as soon as he left the line. So,
okay.
Hello? Yeah.
Yes, sir. How are you?
Who
again, this coach Kasumu Sila here. I try calling the honorable gentleman, but I'm not available. He could not.
Okay.
Because he called.
As soon as he left the line, he called me,
mm-hmm.
and we negotiated the time. He said he will come back, but not for very long. He said he's at a different function right now. But since there are people here waiting, so he's going to call back, but for only 20 more minutes. 20 minutes more, and that's all he can do. And I've accepted that. So I'm waiting for his return. So let's see if he comes back for the 20 minutes. Thank you, though. I appreciate the help.
Thank you.
Yeah, so let's wait. Kamara Lasana, Lasana Kamara, could you please tell us where you're calling from and your contribution to the discussion as we await Salim Sajiba's return?
Thank you, Mr. Kumar. I just have a question for Salim Sajiba. But
why don't you wait? He's coming, yeah.
Thank you.
Okay, just wait. Just stay where you are. Let's hope he comes. And then we will take you two to begin with. But I don't know why he hasn't come. If he said he was going to, it's been a little while now. Yeah, I'm going to call him. I'm going to call him briefly, folks. Since we're talking football, let me entertain you a little style a little bit. I see if I can get up the line. So he's making a try to come back. So please bear with us. I know it's an unusual, you know, show. We don't usually go this way, but sometimes that's what happens when you call people from across Atlantic. While we are waiting, let me share a few things with you. Most of our past shows are now on YouTube. I uploaded at least 11 different audio shows on YouTube last night, including Kula V for Final Show, David Coty, Councillor Janet, and a whole host of other shows that we had before. I put them up on YouTube. So if you go on YouTube, just tap in the Liberian Diaspora Forum, you will see most of our past shows. I'm still trying to catch up. I want to pull as many shows up there as possible. Those are out there. And I also want to let you know that if you have any guests in mind that you think, oh, Salinsa is back, so we're going to stop right there. Mr. Diva?
Yeah, Jim Salinsa, yeah. Diva back on the line.
Yeah, welcome. I want to thank you for making the effort to come back, and your concern you share with me, I've also shared that with the guests, that you are at a different event, and so therefore you're not going to be with us, you know, indefinitely. So we'll keep it at the time you ask for, but we'll just see if we can take a few more questions, you know, as we await that time. It's 3 after 6 here, and I'm assuming it's probably 4 after 11 there, right?
I know that, sir. I wish I had the possibility, but I can only give you 10 minutes, as I said. I have some guests that came over at my house.
So not even the 20 minutes, you're going to 10 minutes. All right. Okay. Well, I'm sure everyone heard that. So you can only do 10 minutes now. So we'll just take the few follow-up callers here. And then, So, Ms. Alassana Kamara, would you want to go ahead with your question quickly?
All right, Mr. Diva, thank you so much for taking this question. I understand that he is running for the leadership for LFA. But my question I'm going to wait with my first. Leader must possess the quality they are trying to incorporate into their team. For example, if you want your members to be confident, have self-control, be disciplined, and etc., then you must first possess all those characters. One of the most powerful things you can do is to lead by an example. You serve as an example for your players, and everything you do will be watched. Do you possess those qualities?
Okay, thank you. Do you possess those qualities that he outlined?
I definitely possess the quality. As far as I'm concerned, I will never suspend it for any out of malfeasance. So I definitely possess the quality, sure. That answered the question.
Okay. This is a follow-up caller, a fellow you know very well, from based on his first question, 2170. Would you please call your name again and hurry up with your follow-up question?
I will take only one more question, sir.
It keep getting harder and harder. Okay, well, 2170, you be my last caller then. So go on with your follow-up question so we can leave it there for today.
Hello?
Go ahead. Go ahead. 2170,
Yeah, Diva.
Yes, sir.
This is Diva, Elijah D. Agiri. I think you know him personally. I want you to throw, ask you that question. You said that you're going to blow a lot of horn. But, you know, when it comes to promotional fighter, it does have to do with secret, you know, because you are putting your energy, you are putting your time. And then your late days, you tell me today that you are in the instrumentality of assisting and Christopher Ward to get to Europe. I'm not convinced. I mean, with that, because I know Christopher Ward played with the 2 games to get himself. When Christopher Ward went professional, you were out of the year. You were in Cameroon, and then later you came back on your break, and you and Joe Nagwe had to actually leave to go to France, if my remember serves me right. Okay, because I was down there.
No, to a point of correction. I went to France before Joe Namu, please. I went to France before Joe Namu.
Listen, you guys came from Cameroon, and you went to France.
Mr. Diba is running out of time. So, Mr. Diba, we have, how you call this guy, your friend, Coach Sila. I'm sure you wouldn't mind taking him after. So he will be the last caller. I'm sure he got nothing but positive stuff to say.
So after
2170, hurry up. Just wrap up your point, and then we'll take Kasimu Sila and get out of here. Your line is still open, 21-17. Yeah.
Yeah, what I'm saying, I don't want Diba to keep it as a secret because it's your ability of time. I came to the States. I assisted people that came ahead of me before. I tell people. I would not keep it and say, you got to tell people your time. You are putting to assess people. Because we're all on the ground and we know who assisted people to get you.
I answered the question earlier on during the conversation, during the interview. I
got to say it before you say that.
Okay, all right.
Yeah,
21-17, I'm sorry. Apparently, the guest has nothing further to say about that. I've closed your line. I apologize. I'm not being rude, but the guest is not willing to offer anything else on that. So we'll take Kasimu Sila and probably the last caller for the night in keeping with Mr. Diba, you know, desire to get off the show. Mr. Coach Sila, your line is open. Welcome to the Liberian Diaspora Forum.
Thank you very much again. I want to say thanks to my teammate and my captain, senior player, Liberia Most.
Hey, Kasum, what's up, baby? What's up, my brother? What's up?
Thank you. Yeah.
Okay.
First, I want to say thank you very much for participating into the Kasumu M. Sila annual tournament in 2006, when we generated our fund to help build the office space, and you personally gave me $100 as an assistant to the program. I just want to say thank you so much. I still remember that, and you always ask anything that you want me to do, you would assist. And also, I just came from Liberia, saw you coaching but mentoring the BYC because they were representing Liberia in international competition. And
exactly.
Won their first and second game, so I just want to say thank you so much for that again.
Thank you very much.
So many people
might
not know you from the different angle, but I think I perceive it from a different ideology. Diba, for what I know, I think one can transform from being hiding behind the scene and coming publicly. Most of the brothers you see today on the show are people who are your fans and people who supported you back in the days, but they stay in doubt to know exactly what really happened, that Diba was not a world best player when Opon became a world best player. But I know everybody, like you answered clearly, success is in the eyes of the beholder. And if you think this is enough for you, it's enough for you. And if you look at Liberia history, I think there's no player that has done more than you for the Liberia national team. I can tell anybody that. Okay. Thank you for your services. But this is my question. Question number one has to do with the former national team players on the ground, headed by Washington Blay, and we have the pro US. I mean, we have the senior
Washington
pro.
Blay,
we have the senior pro playing on the other side. And what are we doing to galvanize our effort to advocate for our present non-Liberian players, at least on the issue of the SKD Sports Complex hotel that's been given to the Chinese people, making our national team homeless, knowing exactly that Liberia would not go anywhere when the national team is homeless. In the case of Patrick Doppler that came, because he never had a place to reside, he had to stay in the vice president for administrator house. He ended up leaving, going in a nightclub because he was not hosted officially. So what are we doing to at least as a pressure group so that we can renegotiate the contract that's been signed for 30 years? I think we've gone 5 years now for, I think, $8.8 million or $7.5 million. What are we doing as former national team players to at least advocate for our brothers so that they will have a place to be when they come? Being a former professional.
That's
and
true. You're right, Kasumu.
Okay.
Question number two is the issue of this insurance for national team players. National team player have no insurance. Patrick Doppler came, he died in Liberia, nobody know what happened. Now George Diplo is suffering from concussion. My brother, Dr. Sila, we just went to Liberia as head of the FEMUSA medical team. We talked to him. He has voluntarily agreed to host George Gipro here in Atlanta, and he has a sport medicine. He had a facility that he treats concussion that he's going to do that because he's a Liberian. So it's not just going to be in the case of George Gipro. As we live in Liberia and hang around the big guys in politics, what are we doing to seek the welfare of our former player, present player, and
Thank you, Mr. Sila. Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, Kasumu, thank you for your contribution. Thank you very much for your contribution. I mean, you've been here. You saw how things are run. This is a delicate question. It is. But I'm not in a position to answer that question. When I take over as president of the association, I think the contract with the hotel will have to be revisited. And I'm sure I can guarantee you that we'll have to go through the contract. And with regards to putting what you talk about, you did mention about George Gibro and some other former players. Yeah, you were not here, but I think it was last week I had a meeting and the players came from all over. We converged and we had, some very vital discussions to see how we can move this thing forward. I mean, with regards to former national team players. Look, Kasumu, I must give Mr. Bele the kudos for commercializing football. But at the same time, he did commercialize football at the detriment of the players. What do we have to show for it? Let me give you for an example. Look at the Nigeria game, the past Nigeria game. The money they collected, they accumulated close to $800,000. Close to 800,000 United States dollars. What happened to that money? No check and balance. No check and balance. He didn't have a fallout with his VP, Peter Lawrence. Peter Lawrence threatened to resign. They're going through the legal process as we speak. So you see, under my tenorship, what I would do, as I said previously, I would bring the best brains. Those that have been around football, like you, Kasumu, you've been here, you participated in some of the meetings. All of us, you, Namwe, Opong, I'm sure Opong will be willing to come because I've talked to him and other people to see how we can move this thing forward, Kasumu. It's now or never. Look at the trend of football in Liberia now. Look at our ranking. Unlike the George Weah era. This is what I said from the beginning of the show. I said, during the George Weah era, Liberia were on that pedestal of international relevance in football. But look where we are now. We're not happy. But what can we do? You and I, we're on the fence. You know, we're not in the forefront. We're only trying to use our power because of our affiliation with the power structure. We're trying to dance around and see how we can get things accomplished. But that's not much we can do until we take over.
Okay.
So you see, for now, everything is at an impasse. We have to wait and see what happens.
Okay. All right. Well, folks, Mr. Jim Salensa Diba, I want to thank you again. I know there are too many of you who have made entry to ask, but Mr. Diba has indicated that this is all the time he had to be on this show, at least this time. I don't know if we're going to have him
back.
Yeah,
I'm sorry. It's unfortunate.
So your questions are here. I'm looking at it, but except that I can't take them because the guest has other engagements.
Yeah.
He got private engagement to go
to. I would love
to
come on the show again.
We want to
respect
that.
I would love to reappear. Yeah.
Okay. So,
it's 11:15 p.m. on our end here, and I got some people who came. I got some guests at my house, and it's...
All right, Mr. Diba, we understand that, and obviously I won't ask for closing remarks unless you chose to. That's strictly up to you, but you are pressed on time.
if you want
to do closing remarks, that's fine. We want to thank you for your time and wish you well in your endeavor. Thank you, and you have a good night.
I want to tell you thank you for the acknowledgement, man. Thank you. Thank you very much. The honor is all mine. Thank you very much. I really appreciate it.
Thank you.
All right.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Yeah, that is it for Mr. Adiba. Okay, bye. So, Jim Salinas Adiba has. Yeah. Hello? Hello? Okay. So, Mr. Adiba has left us, and there's still a very good number of you here. And let me see what Flomo. Flomo was one of the people waiting in the queue. Brother Flomo, what's up?
Yeah, so my brother, I just wanted to tell my brother that maybe somebody, I think Sion already said this, I just wanted, but he left us already. I wanted to tell him that he might feel, for me personally, if I was in Liberia and in that position, I was going to cash my vote for him. But I want him to know that politics, Liberia Football Association is a politics is an institution that belongs to the Liberian people, but it has become a political institution. And with that, he should remember that he did something to fellows that have power in politics, that have political capital. And now that he's going here, he should expect that somebody is going to hurt him, because I don't know, he hurt somebody the 2005 campaign and 2011. So except that he has a political capital because the president is on his side, maybe. But other than that, he should expect somebody to do the same to him. So wish him good luck, and that's what I have to say.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you, Mr. D-Flow. And obviously, we're leaving from here rushing to Destiny Debater for your tonight show. Thanks for your contribution. So once again, folks, if you have anything else to end off our night, I can open every line, but I think it's best we keep the lines closed and take people one at a time. The former Lone Star player, 2170, is back. 2170, welcome back to the forum.
Hello?
Yeah, hello?
Yeah, my brother, thank you very much. Anyway, I don't know your phone name, but you can give me your text. You can send me your text, and I'm going to get your name and your number for me to try to be participate in most of the show. Because I like this type of discussion, and as I've already said, I say I play for the Amewe, I play for Barrow, I play for Liverpool. I went to second division high school, Diba knows me very well, but somehow we're not lucky to have been in a position to have gone professional. All of my days, I went to school on scholarship. I went to Memorial College. I worked for Social Security before coming to America. You know, I served in a regional coordination office, and I served as assistant director for inspection. So it's a good thing for us to discuss about our country. So, but let me get closer with this, what I really wanted to say, you know, concerning and what the question I posed to Diva, you know, why he's thinking to come to the FA, because you might be able to, you might have that managerial skill, you might have the ability, you know, to be able to relate to people. You know, when they play and scoring goal and performing is good, but if you can convince people to come on board to make things happen for your country, it's a very good thing. You see, your career to elevate people is a very good thing. It almost like the same way being in a position. Look at our country, my brother. We are the only country in the world that produce world best. And we don't have an academy. Now, what I always tell people to say, oh, you need to talk about here again. We should have been in the position to have given our chance to Josh Rea to become the FS chairman. When I was in Liberia, I was invited to one of the first meetings. The Liberian people dashed on most of our hope. Josh Rea gave a lot of things to offer for the Liberian people, but it's slapping in the face. They say that the FS lyrics say, I just want to share that with you, maybe you guys are in America. The FS say that they were not invited to any meeting that Josh Rea was, you know, because any team having four division and they having a meeting, I think FA should be informed that they're having an election process. They say they get never the unnecessary citation for any kind of team or the battle defender people to say that George Rea was a president for the football team. I mean, it's so back, you've been so bottleneck on somebody, you get so autocratic on people, you know. George Rea, he has something that Liberian people, you're not even so, tell us, hello, I won't be FA chairman. We so say, look, come and be the FA chairman. Look at the future top. That Josh Rea, through Seth Blatter, our Liberia, Josh Rea helped to make it crappy in our country. Executive Wesley, they should have technical meetings and say, no, we're not present to any executive meeting, so Josh Rea can be president.
It's been wicked. But that's the problem, my brother. We have problems in this country. Roger Miller, I just want to reflect some of the Roger Miller in Indonesia, retiring from his career. We have all the guys on the team, some of the young guys, they say, look, Roger Miller is still playing, we need his input. They went, they discussed it with the youth and sport minister, and they discussed with the president gets, the mayor said, we need Roger Miller on the team. Roger Miller was playing retirement football Indonesia. He came and scored on Argentina. So, is it, and now, look at the services in the country. We got to appreciate people there who have performed, who have reached to that level. Say, look, we also can't even for John. We are so first to be FA chairman. We don't want to make John. We are saying he won't be president for Labrador today. We are supposed to get it to him on the platform, say, John, we are. Yeah. Because the services you run for football in that country, you know what I mean? No first black man win that thing. I don't know if you're in America when they give the Lion Legacy Award. Black players and black people crying to see the type of award that ball win. We don't know the value of that ball win. We don't know the value of what George Miller possesses.
Let's hear from other people. Yeah, okay. Your point is well taken. I'll keep you here. Let's hear from somebody else. Folks, next week, Sunday, it appears that we got three possible guests lined up. Brother Senior had mentioned someone to me who would like to speak on public health. But I spoke with Brother Samuka, the Minister of Defense. It's possible we could have him coming next week to talk about AFL ongoing recruitment and also Liberia participation in the peacekeeping mission in Mali. I spoke with him. He was very busy. He did say I should call him back, but he said that's a possibility. And also, Representative Marima Fofana hasn't been on the line. I chatted with her on Facebook this morning. She's also a possibility. So, just so you know, we got a few guests lined up. Any one of whom could be our guest next week. I just wanted to let you know that. So, 79-0-5, 79-0-5. We're trying to finish up our time here. What's your take on the subject on the discussion?
Yes, Kapumo Kuma, this is Duane again. This is my first time actually on your program,
okay.
And I think it's a great program.
Thank you.
If you know issues in the press, I'm the project manager for that. So I just wanted to let you know, I appreciate the fact that you're having this. I think it's given me the courage to be able to come on again to keep looking at it, because when we run issues in the press with Algerum, your one comes on the show as well too. It's always good to support each other and get to know what's going on. I think this is a perfect opportunity for us to know what sort of thing is going on. So I
appreciate the invitation. Yeah.
And most of the people that are also calling just know that when the information came to me, I forwarded it to most of the players because I have a lot of the contact around the country.
Okay.
So because what I do, the Pro US is a sport-based organization. But just before Diba came on, I talked to him, and he told me, yes, he was coming on here, and I talked a little bit before he came on today. But, you know, there's a lot of stuff going on. There are a lot of stuff going on in Liberia. It's just unfortunate that the Liberian Football Association, the only people that can vote are those that on the executive team and those people that own teams in the country. It's also unfortunate that Mr. Diba, being a leader, he wants to be a leader, and he's not listening sometimes some of these questions to end. You know, and being sometimes as a leader, you have to be a good listener versus a fast talker. You know, and I hope that I know he can do his best, but he has to sit and get more information and try to get a lot of things. That will be done. In fact, just recently during the Patrick Chia funeral, we had a lot of the players came down, and I have a special presentation that I did had to present, including the George, because I talked to him many times too. But you know, the reason I asked that question for the athletes union is because a lot of things are happening, and he knows that we talk about it. And coming to the ascendancy of the FA, it's just not mere talk; a political talk. You know, these things have to be done with honestly and patriotism. So their presentation we have had, their presentation that I've done, over 100 page slides document, over 75 page document that I presented to them and also to the FA, you know, about sport development. There are a lot of things that we can do, you know, and the only thing is he needs to listen in some of these ideas. You might not take everything, but it's always good to listen. If I was going to talk to him, and I've always talked to him about that, don't talk too much, try to listen and give some of these ideas, you know, because it could help you potentially.
Yeah.
So hopefully he could be able to come back again someday on the show so that we can all, I mean, individually we will talk to him, but we all got to be able to let him know that the F8 sport is a multi-billion dollar industry, but Liberia is the only country that are not making use of it. I've talked to the president, in fact, I've submitted a proposal to, in fact, George himself as well. Now, there are a lot of other things going on beyond the scene, but I'm glad that you were able to invite him to be part of this process. And hopefully he will come back on again and just listen and be able to give some of these comments and these strategic ideas that we have. So we
right
can
on.
See the bigger picture. Thank you.
Right on. Thank you. And I tell you right now, personally, I have no doubt that James Salinsa Diba could make a good LFA president. But I must say, from what I heard tonight, I'm a bit worried that if he does become LFA president, chances are he's going to have serious issue with the press. Now, it's one thing to be a million miles away on the phone and say, I don't want to talk about politics, I don't want to talk about sport, or it's one thing to say, I can only do 20 minutes, or if I can only do 10 minutes now, or I got people here. That's one thing to do, and it's altogether a different thing when you are surrounded by the press, when you are confronted. There's no way anyone can run very many institutions in Liberia independent of politics. I found that very hard to believe, but good luck to him. I really like the man, and I hope he wins. We'll see what happens from there. Mr. Sino, welcome back to the show. What's your take?
Man, Brother Kuma, I can't stop thanking you and many others. I just want to echo the sentiment expressed by my brother Zizé earlier when he acknowledged your show opening when our guests were on, and also with the comment closed by my own dear brother D. Duana Sayan. When I sent him the number, like I said, I was going to promote your show any day, anytime. He called me and said, my man, oh, what do you want me to do? You want me to send it to the rest of the players around the world? I said, please do that. That's how he sent it out. So, yes, more people came on to listen to him. And I just say this to say that you, Liberian Diaspora Forum, Brother D-Flow, Liberian Destiny Debater, and, of course, Issue the Press Reloader, Jerome, and I can't forget my man, the independent, all of you, and even Voice of Jeter, all of you guys, even the Liberian Journal, all of you guys are truly making our community what it ought to be. And I just want to seize the time to thank all of you media, even though we're on your show, but I know you are very flexible. You allow me to express thanks to your colleagues because you guys are bringing us information. And I'm so glad it came from you. I was a little bit disappointed in our guests. But it's by the same token, we have to respect, you know, our guests. As always, whether we like them or not, we agree with them or not, we have to respect them because they're our guests. You know, if I were in our shoe, I want to be respected as guests. So we have to respect them. But I'm glad I came from you instead of coming from people to us, you know, because people to us were so critical, you know, so the man critical. But at least you, the host, you expressing your disappointment. I agree with you 100%. I don't think he showed any good statementship. Well, the man has guests to the house too, it can be fair to say. But hopefully he will come back to redeem the time. Other than that, I think he will go down in my black book as one of the least guests or least favorite guests we have on our show. Having said that, I'm glad that you also mentioned that, you and D-Flo mentioned that. I don't know how he can devolve politics on what he's doing. You know, the only backing I can hear him saying over and over, power that be, power that be. He's banking on the president's support. Whether this president can be trusted to support him to that different thing, because you can't trust this president. You can't pass anything by her. You know, she's a very smart politician. You may disagree with her politics, but I give her high respect for that because she's very cunning in her politics. Maybe she might have somebody she favors more than Diba. Who knows? But, you know, let's see what happens. But I hope he will get to see those that his friend Judge Weah gets so he can know what it means to have interest in. Because politics is simple, one simple thing. It's interest.
So all that support, George Weah will do, George Weah will do. You know, now he emphasizing George Weah. Why he gets to the president, That's why you have to be careful. This is a warning to all of us on this phone. It, no matter how you disagree with your friend or your brother, be very careful how you vote against the person because it will come back to haunt you. You may need them many ways. You know, and what happening now? He emphasizing George Weah, George Weah, George Weah, because he definitely needs George Weah blessing. Why you can't call the president? So also you only equip George Weah to soccer. You know, but anyway, but they are two brothers, they will handle the thing. Thank you so much for your show, my man.
Thank you. Yeah. They are cousins. Thank you. They can handle you. But yeah, you're right. From our from where we sit, I think if LFA President Salinsa Diba is going to succeed, he has definitely got to learn to deal with the press, to deal with issues from fellow Liberians, to deal with simple questions. Because quite frankly, all of the questions that came up here, I don't even know. I didn't hear the hardest questions. Of course, I guess if you're not answering the questions, you don't know what side was easy. But I thought most people who came on here tonight were more for him, you know, becoming LFA president than against. And as such, as I was giving to him, I thought they were fair questions, except that he keep cutting the time, and then talking about we decided we'll not discuss politics. Well, I understand that, but you got to put yourself in my shoes. How am I supposed to anticipate what a caller will say? You know, in this day and age where freedom of speech is the talk of the time. So, but hopefully, like you said, I agree. I hope Jim Salinsa Diba will find the time to come on this show or any other show, you know, to redeem himself. Maybe before he becomes president, or shortly when he's elected after the LFA election. I hope he does. But Coach Sila, I know you were in a queue earlier, and there were other people before you, so I'll go back to you. Coach Sila, do you have anything to offer? We're just trying to finish the time here in 10 minutes.
Yeah.
10 more minutes, yeah.
Yeah, I just want to highlight on the way the LFA is structured, and many of our audience would like to know exactly. The LFA has four components, and that is the administration, which is the president, his vice president, and the vice president for operation. Then you have the coaches association. Then you have the media association and the referee association. So the four components are the component put together, comprised of the LFA leadership. Then another audience asked about whether ordinary Liberian can vote. Of course, no, because the LFA statute says that executive committee member, president of first division team, president of second division team, subcommittees, and sub-association. Who are the subcommittee? The subcommittee are the various committee within the community head are the subcommittee. Then the sub-association are the head of all of the county association, the 15th county association. Now, the conflict here, who appoint the sub-association is the president of the LFA, who is now the sitting president. Then the executive committees, the president, his vice president, his vice president for administration and the vice president for operation, and people that were voted by the various first division, second division, women football, sport medic, banking association, Olympic, University of Liberia, you know, PE association, they are people put together to comprise with the executive committee. So they make the decision daily to day meetings, whether to impeach the president, whether to agree on this, you know, this sanction money here. So they are all involved into making decisions. So what is happening now in the LFA is they are all being held up because when the Honorable Musa Bellete led administration took over, all of the executive committee members was credited, or whether they paid back or not, was given $8,000 to buy a car for themselves. So that to show you that they are all enjoying. But then the question that comes to the mind is, what's about the four component, coaching association?
Is the coaching association even have a good facility for coaching? No. Then the next thing is the sport medic. Do we have a facility under the ATS? No. Do we have a facility under the SKD sports complex so that when players fall or you can even jump into the system? No. Do we have even one ambulance? No. So the component, the sport medic, the coaching association, they're not functioning, but everything there is being over the administration. So now the LSA, I agree with so many of us that whether we can vote or we don't have a voting right, but you have influence. What are those influence you have? The various medias like the pro-USA, like what you're doing now. This could be an opportunity for my brother to sell himself. This could be an opportunity to get more men on his side, because I know all of us here, when I hear the name Flomo, maybe I would say he's from Lofa or Bonn. But in Bonn County, you have sub-association. Flomo could call his sub-association here in Bonn County and say, my man, our man voted, you vote for him. You could call him Lofa. So, I mean, to say yes, you can vote, but you have influence. So to buy your vote, also to buy your influence, to buy your support, this was going to be an opportunity for the brother to sell himself. But however, we hope he will come prepared. We hope you will come prepared next time, because so many people don't know what is the diaspora, because this organization is one of the top media organizations that have credible people, that have people who really love Liberia, that will want to come in the show and know exactly what is going on and then recommend to the Liberian people on what to do. Again, in the case of George Weah, you know, the brother came on, he started to talk about the importance of George Weah. But let me let the Liberian people know, George Weah has a position that is bigger than even to be Liberia Football Association president. What is that? George Weah is a lifetime executive committee member of FIFA on player affairs. That is, if you become world best player, you automatically an executive committee member of FIFA, like Maradona, Kim Pele, Frank Breckenberg, you know, all the big players. So, and then Joe Weah is the only African player that became, we know that, you see. So his influence and his position on the world football map is higher than even the LSA. But when Joe Weah came to Liberia to become president, you know, the LFA had a statute, and the statute say you must become a president or vice president of a team before you can become a president or before you can contest. Joe Weah said, okay. We Liberia at the time, even the Ghanaian Federation, other people told Liberian that, well, you both should even be happy. If it was Ghana, we were just going to say, take it. I agree, but there are procedures. If we Liberia wanted Joe Weah to become president at the time, with the FA, like a brother Ragley said, we was going to say, my man, yeah, this is going to be symbolic. You're president of Barca December. But when Joe Weah went to Grand Barca and they elected him, LFA said, well, the statute also says an election to become a president of a club must be what? Witness and sanctioned by LFA. You know, because why, they didn't want him to be, so that got him mad, he left.
Bro, Cassie, let me ask you, so is that's an interesting point you made right there. So has, yes, Salensa Diba been a president or a vice president of a team? Is he now, or has he been ever?
He has not begun a president or vice president, but after all of that, the FIFA came back again to change the statute to say that a meaningful sport lover that loves soccer can contest. So that statute has been changed. But equally so, the LFA has a right. I think you've been hearing that Musa Belede wanted to follow Issa Ayatou format. So CAF is the Confederation of African Football. So CAF is also saying now that even though FIFA said that as a recommendation in FIFA statute, but CAF is the one that really supervised, because why? LFA 4 honor a confederation, which is CAF. So Issa Ayatou is saying to become a president over that situation because we witnessed that people come up from different organs to want to become president of the FA, but then they inject politics and they don't have that requisite knowledge. So an executive committee member within the association should contest. So that's just his recommendation. You see?
Okay, yeah. Just to take a break there. Thank you for that information. Let's hear from somebody else here. Don't go. Stay where you are. Folks, be reminded that we are just finishing up the show. I think we just got probably 8-9 minutes left, so we can get out of here and get ready for another show at 7 o'clock on Destiny Debater. 6929, our guest has left, so we're just finishing up from where he left off. 6929, please tell us your name, where you're calling from, and your contribution.
Mr. Kumar, how you doing?
I'm doing great, sir.
This is Donovan. I want to thank you so much for this show.
Thank you.
Yeah, actually, what I needed to know from the guest that was on your show, he did not respond to the way I wanted him to have done. So I was a little bit disappointed about that. And secondly, I don't know how much preparation your guest might have made in that bureau to become a person of LFA. For instance, some of the initiatives or some programs that you have written that you have for Liberia, for Liberian Football Association, we don't know. So we were expecting that your guests would explain all of that to us instead of banking on another player that Josh Weir, as everyone has said. You know, so we were expecting that. You know, the way that's why we want to know more. We want to know more about, for instance, plans that the person who is contesting certain positions that Bureau has for the Bureans or even for the LFA. Your guests are not able to see all of that. So I was very disappointed.
My brother, I agree with you 100%. And look, I'm more disappointed than you are. Keep in mind that I didn't call Jim, unlike David Coty, unlike Downtown City Mayor, people that I called midnight and scheduled them the very next day, unlike those two. I contacted Jim Salinsa Deepa last week, Monday. So since then, I've been in constant contact with the brother. I talked to him yesterday, day before yesterday. So, of course, he knew this show was coming up. So for him to come and not ready and be at a different occasion and yet promise him to come on the show and come and then be tight on time, you know, and not answering questions, I'm just as disappointed as you are. But so such is the game. What can I do? You know, the man has the right to his speech. If he doesn't wish to talk to us any longer than he did, who can? We don't have any contempt power, like I said at another forum yesterday. But I'm disappointed. I apologize to you. I wish there's a way I could make it up to you. That's why we're trying to finish up the conversation the way we are. But I agree. Flomo, welcome back to the show. We're trying to be quick here.
My brother, I think many of your callers have almost said, they have come up with great points, and I agree with some of them. Some of them I disagree with them. Let's give every – Jim Steba has – he's a Liberian. Let him go into the race. If he comes up victorious, so be. If not, he sit on the side. He will learn politics. Maybe he thinks that the LFA is not a political institution. It is. So let him go in there, play his game, come out, learn something, and then maybe go back. So that's all I have to say, my brother, because I have about 15 minutes to Liberia Destiny Debaters program. So let me let you go. I have to get back to the studio.
Thank you. We'll be there. But I have to disagree with you as much as I'll be there. Do I think that anything, not just Jim Salinsa Deepa, do I think that anybody else, especially someone of Jiba's record, will be a better LFA president than Musa Benitez? You better do, absolutely. I'm disappointed with Musa Benitez LFA chairmanship as well. Let me go on record for saying that. Since he became chairman, I don't know what Liberia's football has achieved. So to see Mayor Jim Salinsa Deepa step forward, I applaud him. I think that's a good thing to do. And so it is because of that I was expecting more out of him today than I got. So that's where my disappointment comes through. That's why I'm a bit frustrated. But we'll see what happens. But I can tell you that if he thinks that LFA is non-political, he has to think again. As a matter of fact, there's nothing non-political in Liberia today, today Liberia that I know. So he has got to work on that part. But I wish him well, as I said. First, we're trying to get out of here. We got just, 6 more minutes left. 69, 29, you came back. Please hurry up.
Yeah, yeah,
get us out of here.
I want to make this last comment to say that being LFA president, coming to speak about football association is not political. Anything we do, for instance, you ask a friend getting water to drink, that's politics. Politics is every action we do in this world in our interest. That's politics. So anything that he's doing in Liberia right now and think that is apolitical, that is not true. Aristotle even said it, that every man is a political animal. We are all political animals. So we should not forget about that. So we should give that advice to him that to be admitting in public forums that he's doing something that is apolitical. It's not true.
Thank you. I agree. Okay, we'll just take two more and then we'll get out of here. 2170, please be brief. Please be brief so we can get out of here soon.
Hello?
2170, yeah, hello. Can you please be brief?
Yeah, very, very brief. I just want to add to maybe Diva just forgetting to know that football is politics. Okay, let me just bring his remembrance back to Maribaru Day when Alhaji Kuman came into the race. Nobody knew Alhaji Kuman to become a Baru man. I'm giving you real experts. I was playing for Amewa at that time. Ellen Mellon was a man on the ball. Men met 2 days before the election. The late president, Sandor Kayan, those for Alhaji Kuman, Paul Moriba to the executive mansion. Say, I need Alhaji Kuman to be president for Maribaru. So I just want to say that interest, the whole world, is networking. Now, Alhaji Kuman become Maribaru president today. Is you on the ground? I'm telling you today, I'm a people I've met with. Baru said they don't want Alhaji Kuman, they don't know him. Even after Alhaji Kuman become president, Washington Bay still have problem with Alhaji Kuman. He even went in the newspaper saying he won a clearance. Baru lost 5 gold games in a row. Ask them about it, his story is there. They are a people for Baru. So I don't know, life as a whole, and he say it's political. In the past, he never gave dream and vision to his brother, but now he want to back him. Today, the artificial talk I just told you about, who cast the last vote for Seth Blatter, or not George Weah, make the research. Former footballer, the world best, contested in that race. George Weah cast Seth Blatter vote. That's why he say, I will take it to my country to see what you can do. That's how the artificial talk was built. Try and call Josh Weah in the studio and you don't hear that from him. Then you call them and say, you lie. So now, why? That's how to share with you people.
The whole world is not working.
The whole world.
Yeah, thank you. We live in political era. I'm really disappointed to see someone say that, this is politics, this is not. There are very few things, that are non-political today. And by the way, I just test my number my phone number to you. You said you wanted my number so I can add you to my list. So I just check your text message. You should have my phone name and my phone number. We will hear from just a few people here, and then we'll call it a night. Brother Sila, can you please be a coach? Sila, sorry. Can you please keep it brief so we can get out of here? Yeah.
Yeah. One thing, honestly, before the national team travel, a representative of the Minister of Youth and Sports that represents government must travel. That make it political. One. Two, the players have to travel on an official passport and not expire, and that had to be signed by the Minister of Foreign Affairs. That make it political. And before the game starts, the two national athletes will have to show up between CAF, if it's CAF competition, FIFA, or the host country, the visiting country, where the referee is coming from here and there. So honestly, in my own view also, we're very, very disappointed that we did not know exactly how this thing is being structured or run. Again,
right.
I just want to say thank you for inviting us, because so many people will say, yes, the mayor wanted to become president, and why the diaspora did not give him the opportunity. Now you have given the opportunity, and it's there for us as farmer player. We the farmer player. I know you guys supporting us, you guys want us to be out there, but we also have to have that requisite knowledge to be able to best represent the institution. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Sila. I couldn't agree more. Thank you. Just two people left here. We'll take two more, actually, and then we'll call it a night. 7905. Please remind us your name again and your contribution as we close the show. 7905.
Kafuma Kroma, this is Duwana again, and I want to say thank you, Coach Kasumu M. Sila, from the Kasumu Sila Foundation, for that education, because there are a lot of people who are interested in sport but might not know much about how the structure run in an elephant. And that was a very good education, and I appreciate it. And just like everybody has seen, again, Diva kind of a little surprised some people, some of us, and I hope that he's going to be able to come back and re-clarify that, because we were hoping that he was going to get his platform. In fact, the introductory statement was very short. We didn't even get much of a stuff from there. And then, because normally when you come into this thing, then the politics. Even if you get the president back in, that's politics, because the president is going to say, well, I'm going to back you, or maybe trying to get upon on his side to vote for him. That's also politics. You know, he's also doing politics right there. But again, some people look at politics different. But everything you do, again, like everybody's saying, is politics. He's trying to get George. He's trying to get the president's support. He's trying to get other executive committee support, executive committee member support. So those are all politics he's doing. But again, I don't know what else he's doing in the country in terms of the media, what he's doing to reach out to the media. But he has to be careful what he says out there. Otherwise, I can tell you, Musa Blade, because I've invited him on Issue in the Press before, I believe that this guy, if he's not careful and he does not go back in his shelf to revisit his way, his answer question, it's going to be a little difficult for him. It's going to be challenging for him in this race. Thank you.
Thank you. Well, it looks like we all agree on one thing, that we it was a disappointment. And I found that very, very frustrating, because when I was growing up, Opa Opina Salensa closing, when we're hearing those things, one other thing I heard from time to time was that Jim Salensa Diba was the most eloquent, the most political national team player, at least compared to George Weah, but that certainly was not noticed tonight. So we'll hear last from Brother Singer, will be our last discussion for the night, and then we will get out of here. Mr. Singer, welcome back to the show.
Yes, brother, thank you so much. Let me also join my brother, Duana, to thank Brother Sila. I don't really know him personally like I know you and know other people, but anything a Liberian does that benefits our people, I think it's only fair for us to keep applying ourselves, keep giving people the commendation so we can empower them. So, Brother Sila, if you're on the phone still, I say God bless you. Thank you for your foundation. Just keep doing what you're doing. If you can just help one person, that's enough. If you can help two people, that's enough. Three, that's enough. But thank you for the foundation. Let me close on this. The only politics Diva doesn't want to talk is the hard question, why did he not vote for Opon and vote for Madam Ellen Johnson Sirleaf? That's all he's trying to avoid. If you listen to him intently, he kept going back to the power that be, the power. But then if you're asking the real question, oh, boy, but what happened with your own brother? You jump your brother and take another person over your brother. That's the politics he doesn't want to talk about. He didn't expect that this question was coming up. But people need to tell our guests, these forums, when they come on this forum, they should be expecting hard questions, because this forum provides opportunity for us to be clear and respectful, and we'll give you the hard question. That's the politics he's trying to avoid. He's not stupid. He know what was coming for him, so he tried to avoid. I bet you that's why he cut his own shirt, because he felt that, wait a minute, he got an honor cutting me, they're coming too hard, let me slow down. Ask me about Opon, he will tell you that he can't talk politics, but tell you about Eric Johnson said he will tell you he can't talk politics. Brother, God bless you for your work you do, man. Liberia will live because of people like all of us. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Brother Singer. Thank you, and thanks to everyone. As usual, it is a pleasing pleasure to have you all come on here to engage our guests. We are very delighted that we all met here tonight. And as I said, please, and oh, by the way, please check us up on Facebook. Please like us on Facebook. We are really monitoring our Facebook page. And go on YouTube. We got a bunch of videos there, audio recording for past shows. This one will also be out there before sometime, before the end of the week. I'll make sure to put this up on YouTube. I put a whole lot more there last night, so please check YouTube for our past recording. Please check us up on Facebook. And don't forget, next week, we could have Brother Samuka, the defense minister. We could have Mariama Fofana, Lofa County District Number 4 representative. We could have Senator Groupie. Or we could have a guy that Barasenio, you know, has recommended. We'll see who's available. I will work out the schedule. But all of those names that I just called are people that I've spoken to, with exception of Barasenio's guest. But I spoke with Groupie, I spoke with Mariama Fofana, and I briefly spoke with Brandon Samuka. So we could have any one of those people next week, Sunday. So with that said, you have a wonderful night, and thank you.